Hip Hop Connection.
We're here on Hip Hop Connection on the Voice of America. We have a very special in-studio guest. He goes by the name of W. Ellington Felton.
Oh, my mic sound nice. Check one. My mic sounds nice. Check two. My mic sounds nice. Check three. Say you ready? Is my aroma that of an exotic fruit? Why do you seek to devour? 'Cause my meat is the delicious truth. Because I have risen this hour, hold thy peace, I will not yield. Oh no, I know my love sustains me. Faith in the reward is my shield. For he hath preordained me. I was covered with love, lust and hate. A hunger for you turned into a day. Oh, ooh, marinating in the both of us. Where do we begin? Let us discuss. Oh, I was covered with love, lust and hate. A hunger for you turned into a day. Marinating in the both of us. Where do we begin? Let us discuss. Ooh, break it down. 'Cause I stumbled upon a diary, the main character was described so scary. Who could this be? My mind wandered. It was me. She called me a monster. It was me. She called me so selfish. She described the scene. Oh, oh, and so helpless. She said, because I spoke loud. She wasn't talking. She said, because I picked her over the crowd. We had to quit walking, so she wrote it down. Wrote it down, made it permanent, wrote it down, like a tattoo on some loose leaf paper. She made it permanent, but I really appreciate your help. I really appreciate your help. I do. Really appreciate your help. You really did a great job. Yeah. You really did a great job of helping me learn how to hate myself. Hate myself. Hate myself. You taught me how to hate myself. Hate myself. You know, I don't wanna share my love with no one else. If my love feels like that, you know what? I want it back. Give it to me, yeah, so I can kill it, and no one else can feel it. Ooh, ooh, I wanna kill it. This is the diary of a monster. That's all it is. Don't you ever worry, can you feel it coming? This monster of a love. This is the diary of a monster. I want it back so I can kill it, and no one else can feel it.
W. Ellington Felton right here on Hip Hop Connection. What's going on, man?
What's happening? Peace, peace, the world. Yeah, peace, world. How y'all doing?
Man, I'm glad to have you here. Been many years in the making. You are so eclectic when it comes to music, and you're so busy with music. Mm-hmm. Your whole life just kind of surrounds music. How did that all begin for you?
You know, basically, I'm originally from D.C. My father was a jazz pianist named Hilton Felton. My brother got his name, though, but my dad named me W. Ellington Felton, I guess, with hopes that if things didn't work out with my older brother, I would somehow, you know, get in the, stay in the family business, per se.
Okay.
But, you know, I as a kid, I just started off just writing, you know, as a poet and writing a lot of poetry. So, you know, when I was 14 and 15, I was getting snuck into a lot of the venues with people like Tony Blackman and Tony Asante Lightfoot and who else, you know, Brandon Williams and DJ Renegade and Ascari and Willie Ascari, all these poets that were from this area. And they took me under their wing, and you know, I would do things at Soul Brothers Pizza. Used to be at 14th and U. These are the things at Bookham Cafe, and just all around. And ultimately, one day I got picked to participate in this poetry slam reading kind of event at the Apollo Theater with like Sonia Sanchez.
All right,
and, you know, some of the more bigger, Amiri Baraka.
Yeah.
You know, and I was this young kid, and I was like, cool, you know. So that exposed me first that one, my voice was something that people were interested in, as you know, to check out. So that developed me. Then I went on to study theater at Carnegie Mellon University. Theater was actually what focused me as a creative rebel, per se.
Okay.
So I went there when I was like in the 11th, 12th grade. I fell in love with Shakespeare and Otho Fugard and August Wilson, all these great playwrights who were using their art for social change. And that impressed me. And I just decided, well, whatever I end up doing, whatever it is, it's going to have to be for the purpose of, you know, bringing creatively the realities of life to the table versus the fallacies that most people in arts and entertainment, you know, settle for.
So what was it about theater that made you focus?
Well, one, you know, it gave me an opportunity to, you know, through a piece called My Children, My Africa by Otho Fugard, a South African playwright. There was a character named Thimbi in there. And I was able to check that guy out. And I was like, wow, there's a scenario where this character is like how I was in high school.
Okay.
You know, I was the guy who would write a poem that was like bashing the DC public school system, but I'd put it like next to the honor roll.
Okay.
But I went to school without walls, senior high school here in DC. So it's one of those schools that kind of like, you know, if you handle your business, you can kind of, they'll find a way, like, all right, you know, calm down a little bit. Let's figure out a way to channel that energy. And by the way, you misspelt some words on that. I said, I know, it was on purpose. I'll make the point. You guys ain't teaching us nothing, right? So one day this teacher was like, hey man, check out this play. This is a South African play called My Children, My Africa. And I want you to check it out. I think you would like this. So I checked it out and I was like, wow, you know what? You know, arts and entertainment is not just about, you know,